how much of your time has been taken up by other people or social obligations. Okay, most of us, we wake up in the morning, go through our little morning ritual, and go to a job that we just hate. You know, we hate our job, we hate being there, and to get through it, we kind of just launch into autopilot. You know, we're there like, okay, autopilot, go through the motions, go through the day, and you know, you go home, go to sleep, wake up, and do the same thing over and over and over again. Okay, and your days kind of fly by, your years fly by, and you look back and you're like, whoa, did I really live during those years? Was I actually doing what I wanted to do, or just kind of going through the motions, giving my life away to, say, social obligations, to my job? You're probably giving it away. Okay, ask yourself, how much have you lost through groundless sorrow, foolish joy, greedy desire, the seductions of society? If you want an example, next time you go on Facebook to check your messages, like, oh, it'll just be 5 minutes. Let me check my messages. Notice how much time actually passes. Okay, and you'll be surprised. You'll be like, what? 20 minutes? An hour? You know, I went to check my messages, and then I surfed the web a bit. I started looking up all the status updates. That's your life. 1 hour just flew by. 1 hour is gone. Did you really live during that hour there? Okay, I doubt it. You were simply preoccupied, and we're constantly preoccupied. We're distracted. We watch movies. Any way we can distract ourselves, and this is why our life just flies by. And we're surprised. We're like, what? Death has arrived? It was so short. Because you weren't actually living. Okay, we dash from one pleasure to another, and we cannot stay steady in one desire. Okay, and a great quote here is, we lose the day in waiting for the night, and the night in fearing the dawn. And it does not matter how much time we are given if there is nowhere for it to settle. Okay, we're just constantly in motion and never actually taking the time to realize, like, hey, what's actually happening? Okay, and the fact too that we're preoccupied, and I love this, we never really look back at our past. Okay, why? Because if we did, it's not very pleasant to recall activities in which we are ashamed of. We're like, what did I do today? I went mindlessly through work and my job, you know, and then I watched this movie and distracted myself for 5 hours, say, watching television. We're not very proud of that, so we just keep on moving forward. So we never even learn from our mistakes. Okay, living life, like actually living, is the least important activity of the preoccupied man. Okay, and he also says here that among the worst offenders, I count those who spend all their time in drinking and lust, for these are the worst preoccupations of all. Okay, and he asks us, do you think that a man, let's just say, who goes out and drinks and doesn't even know if he's standing or sitting down, like, well, it's happening, does he know if he's alive or not? Not really. Okay, or someone half asleep and sluggish after yesterday's drinking, kind of like out in this daze, that's you just gone. You're not there, you're not living. This is not you, again, claiming the day for yourself. Another way of wasting life is by putting things off. And everyone does this. We deny ourselves the present by promising the future. So you're never really living now. You're like, someday. Someday I'll live. And again, you kind of disconnect from living. Okay? And what he says here is that when you hear people say, you know, when I reach this age, or once this event happens, then blah, 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 what guarantee do you have that you're going to live that much longer? What guarantee you have you're going to live until that day? Why deny yourself, again, living now? Start living immediately. What he says is that you are living as if destined to live forever. Your own frailty never occurs to you. You act like a mortal in all that you fear, and like an immortal in all that you desire. Okay, instead of longing for the future and being wary of the present, the man who spends all his time on his own needs, who organizes every day as though it were his last, neither longs for nor fears the next day, for what new pleasures can any hour from now bring him? Now, if, let's just say, you're caught in this rat race of not living, what he recommends here is, first of all, extract yourself from the crowd or the storm and retire into a peaceful harbor. Okay, you need to withdraw yourself from the rat race and take some time for yourself. Okay, take some perspective. However, okay, just be aware that it's not you just staying extracted the entire time. What he says is that these two must be mingled, solitude and joining a crowd. And this is not an invite to be idle or purposeless. Okay, what he says is that when you are retired and enjoying peace of mind, you will find to keep you busy more important activities than all those you have performed so energetically up until now. Okay, you had promised higher and greater things for yourself. Rediscover those higher and greater things. And I love this. Okay, we tend to think like, hey, if I just do nothing, you know, if there's no motivation, I kind of extract myself from, you know, the carrot and the stick, I'll just be sitting there. But in reality, no. Okay, you don't need a carrot or stick for motivation. Let's just say right now you had all the money and all the free time in the world, you wouldn't just sit there. You're like, well, if I'm not going to make money, why would I do it? It's like, no, you wouldn't just sit there. You would do something that you want to do. What he says is that in this life, you will find much that is worth your study, the love and practice of the virtues, forgetfulness of the passions, the knowledge of how to live and die, and a life of deep tranquility. Okay, and realize too that external goods are of trivial importance. Okay, the majority of people are carried away by the surface appearance of things. You know, they trust what he calls fortune. And what he says is that never have I trusted fortune, even when she seemed to offer peace. Okay, prosperity does not elevate the sage, and adversity does not depress him. Okay, for he has always made the effort to rely as much as possible on himself and to derive all delight from himself. Okay, so in terms of what do you want to do, it should be for you not to get anything external. Okay, it was nature's intention that there should be no need of great equipment for a good life. Okay, every individual can make himself happy. The body's needs are a few, and this is very important to reflect on. It wants to be free from cold, to banish hunger and thirst with nourishment, and if we long for anything more, then we are exerting ourselves to serve our vices, not our needs. Nothing satisfies greed, okay, which is why we're constantly preoccupied in the first place, you know, just chasing more and more and more, but even a little satisfies nature. Okay, so be careful. Okay, don't fall into the trap of chasing external things, thinking that at some point, once you have enough, you will feel happy, because you're just gonna be chasing the next thing and the next thing and the next thing. Okay, you have everything you need. Okay, another great quote is, whatever is best for a human being lies outside human control. It can neither be given nor taken away. Only the most worthless of our possessions should come into the power of another. Okay, you already have it all. Nothing else can be added, nothing can be subtracted.